Right, today's session is about injury prevention, and we're in one of those outdoor park gyms to show you a few things of how you can safely do your push-up, dip, a step-up, and a pull-up without injuring your shoulder and injuring your neck and injuring your knee. So let's go take a look. All right, first one we're gonna do is the push-up. Now, in a park, I'm using a bar like this, which is elevated push-up. The thing about this is we're trying to look after your shoulder, so there's a couple of things you gotta look at. And one is depth. So when you're doing this, what I want you to make sure of is when you're dropping down into the push-up, you're not going all the way down and touching that bar, because what happens is you're going to be too far back at that point. We want to look after the front of your shoulder. So make sure when you're doing this, just stay a little bit away from the bar. So when you go down into this position, come down, slow it down, and stop before the bar and pushing away, making sure that every time you do that, you are doing scapular retraction and protraction. Most people sit in scapular retraction, so they'll sit in scapular retraction and then just do elbow work. And what that tends to do is wind you up and through here, because you're not using stress and pushing forward, so you're doing a lot of upper trap work. So make sure when you get to the top of the push-up, so when you're down from here, your top of the push-up, you press away to reset. Okay, don't sit in that position. Make sure you push away. Then you know when you're doing your push-up, you're doing your serratus work. The other thing is hand position. So when you're doing a push-up in a park with a bar, and this is what I see quite a lot, is if you put your hand in this position where your thumb is under and you wrap around the bar, what it does is it, because you've got your thumb this way, it pushes your hand to there, which immediately puts your elbow in a sort of outward position that way. Okay, so your angle changes. It also deteriorates your shoulder. So when you do a push-up, you're sort of internally rotating your shoulder and your elbows flare out wide. Now that's not great for your shoulder. It's okay for your pec, but not great for your shoulder. And we're after injury prevention today. So what I suggest you do, real simple things, is change your thumb position, which will change your hand position and your elbow on your shoulder. So instead of being there, what you go for is thumb that way, which immediately gives you opportunity to put your hand in a straight position that way. And then from that position there, you can then externally rotate the shoulders, which will bring your elbows in a bit and allow you to go on that nice 45 degree angle there and push away. And that's much more, you know, safer for your shoulder, if you like, and it stops you being forced into that position. Last one for the push-up, if you don't have a flat bar in front of you and you've got something like this in the park where your hands are facing forward, that's still great for hand position and shoulder. You just got to worry about depth for this one, because there's no bar here to stop you or guide you how far you need to go. So if you look at this, and sometimes I see this quite a bit, is when people go down into this position, they go all the way down and hang at the bottom there and then push up. Now that does nothing good for the front of your shoulder, and you're not going to get sort of any major strength gains through the pec, because you're going to sacrifice the shoulder. So when you're doing this one, you just got to watch how far you're going down and just gaze about where that bar would be. Stay away from where that bar would be, don't go and touch it, and just try and work on that imaginary depth into that position. Again, try and make sure you do the press at the top. Watch where your elbows are going. Make sure you get that nice 45 degree angle, but just don't go all the way down. You're just gonna hate you in the morning. So dips. Now, if you haven't done dips before and you're trying to work on tricep work, maybe a bit of shoulder, I suggest you start off with the bars for dips, if you've got those, rather than going straight to the seat. Because what that does is it works on your depth, so you don't have to go too low. Because the big thing about dips is people going far too low and really straining the front of their shoulders, so they're not getting any benefit out of them. So what I mean is when you do a little dip like this, you're going down, touching the seat, coming back up again. So you're just learning how to get some movement, get that movement right. So that's a nice safe way of doing it, because you're not going too deep. What you've got to think about with the dip though is your shoulder position. So most people, when they're doing a dip wrong, what they tend to do is they drop down into that elevated position and then stay there. And what tends to happen is they use all their upper traps so much here and no lower traps. And that's just promoting heaps of upper trap tightness. That's the sort of headache thing you might get the next day. So watch that. Make sure when you're doing this, when you drop down, yes, you go into elevation, but when you come out of it, push into depression, so you push your body up, all right? So your spine is going vertical, your shoulders are going down when you push up. Don't leave them up all the time. Push them down when you push up, then you're gonna get a bit of lower trap with the upper trap. Okay, so if you haven't got bars, or you're gonna go to a bench height anyway to get some depth, because you know how to do the dip, couple of tricks on that one too. When you do this dip, it's about shoulder position and you've got to watch it. When you're doing this whole dip movement here, what I see people doing is going far too low and going right to the ground or just below the ground. And if that bench is any higher, what tends to happen is that elbow will elevate past the shoulder. You've got to sort of almost watch your shoulder and make sure when you drop down that your shoulder is always still higher than your elbow. If you can remember that, shoulder high on the elbow, you'll put less strain through here. Okay, so that's number one. You still got to remember about the up and down. So just reiterating that, when you go down, your shoulders go up. Okay, that's normal. When you get to the bottom, okay, make sure your shoulder's higher than your elbow. But when you push up, you then push your shoulders down, so you elevate your spine upwards. Okay, and then you're going to get your lower trap sort of pulling down and back. Now, what I also want you to focus on is shoulder rolling position. Okay. If your shoulder is tight in the front or you don't have the range through that shoulder there and you're going too deep, what tends to happen is your shoulders roll forward. And you see people doing this quite a lot. Now that's going to absolutely wind me up in my upper trap, okay? You've got to really make sure that you don't roll that shoulder forward. Now if that's happening to you because you're tight, well, hey, when you go down, you know, if it's doing this sort of position, you're only allowed to go as far as you can control. So really make sure those elbows are backwards, okay? Shoulders go up and you go down, but just don't let them go forward. Keep them back in that position and then push all the way top. You'll find when you do that, when you get your shoulders in that right position, you get way more tricep anyway, so then you're in the right position for that. Way more benefit, lots of injury prevention, that's what we want. Okay, with pull-ups, I'm not too concerned about the shoulder with this because most pulling things, shoulders are okay. It's the neck position I want to worry about. So with this one, I see people when they're straining too hard or maybe they're not strong enough to do this sort of thing, is when they do a pull-up, they pull their neck forward and they shunt it forward in that position there. So what you've got to make sure of is, one, have your head sort of facing up to the sky, if you like, but make sure it's back into neutral. So when you pull up, it's about the shoulders. Okay, you're not trying to pull with your neck. You've got to pull with your shoulders and then your arms, but you've got to try and as much as you can stop this whole pushing your neck forward, because that's just going to wind you up here and strain you through there. So even if you've got someone to sort of watch you from the side, make sure your head's coming back, you've just got to remember, can I keep my chin back when I do a pull-up so I'm in a nice neutral position? That'll stop you straining through your neck. All right, last one for today is the step up. Now I see a lot of people doing step-ups on benches or a wall, but what you've got to try and focus on is two things, knee position and your hip position. So for your knee position, what you want to focus on mostly is making sure your knee is not rotating inwards or crossing over your foot. If you can think about it not crossing inwards, then you're doing half the job right. What I see people doing is they just push up, immediately it rolls in, and then they re-correct it at the top. The same thing happens on the way down. When they come down, it rolls inwards. Now that's usually one, maybe a coordination thing, but two, a glute thing. And so they've just got to practice trying to keep that knee out. So when they load, they're trying to practice stopping it rolling in. That's half the job, is just being aware and trying to train it to not do that. The other half the job is doing some glute work. But when you're out in the park, if you can practice focusing on really concentrating and not just sort of staring out of space and just doing some step ups, concentrating on your form, you're less likely to cause strain and load through the knee, because when that knee rolls in, it's designed to be straight, right? So if you're rolling in like that, you're going to stress structures on both sides by putting force in the same load bearing there, but the knee's not in that position. Okay, it's supposed to be here accepting the load. If you put it there, it's going to strain it when you go through. Okay, and that can cause all sorts of problems. So make sure that knee is sitting in line beautifully over the middle of your foot. The other part is the hip. Now when you're doing the step up, what tends to happen is your weight bearing on the back foot. So when you step up, you're already in a tilted angle here. Okay, so this position here is not ideal. So when people go up, they start drop down here. Now immediately if I'm dropped down there and sticking my hip out there, I'm not going to be able to control my knee very well. So the hip is directly related to that knee position. So from instead of being there and then coming up and trying to correct, and then when you drop down, it changes again. What you've got to try and do is get it right from the start. So from this position here, I want you to think about engaging that hip in a flexion. So it's almost like thinking about your front leg, sit the hip back in that position. So at least you've got some sort of leveling going on here. The other thing about when you do that is you're going to put the hip in deflection. You're more likely to get your glute working, which is going to help you with the external rotation to stop it going internally rotated, so you're going to get an external rotation. So when you start from that position, you're already pre-engaged and loaded onto the foot. I'm not trying to push off with that foot as much. I'm trying to step up, that's what they call a step up, with the front leg, okay? Rather than, don't push off with the back, because if you're pushing off the back, you're sort of rotating that position, okay? Which is not going to do any favors for that knee. So sit into there, okay? Drive load through the front leg, and then the same thing when you come down, try and sit on the front leg. So again, weight bear, don't just come from up here and then just drop, okay? Don't sort of lead and drop with that one, because you're going to drop the pelvis. And on the way down, if you're thinking about, oh, I'm going to drop the pelvis here, do you see what that does to my knee? Just bang, internally rotated. So from here, think about, you know, you got to think about the way up and sitting, thinking about the way down to try and get some sort of level there. More engagement of the hip, more glute, better knee control. That's it for this week. See you next time.